Dear brothers and sisters, today, 24th Sunday in Ordinary Morning, we hear three well-known parables about the loving mercy of God. Ours is not a distant God who strictly imposes his will. Rather, Jesus regards God as full of mercy and rich in compassion. He is like a shepherd who loves on his sheep and goes looking for every just one that gets lost. And he is like a woman who sweeps the house clean to seek for a woman she has lost. In this Eucharist, with our priest presider, Reverend Father Joseph Mark, let us approach our gracious and merciful God and Father with confidence as we celebrate this memorial of Jesus Christ, his Son. Please arise for the entrance procession.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Sa gitna ng madla. Ang handog ko, O Diyos, na karapat-dapat, ay ang magumabat, pusong mapagtapat.
Would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds him. And when he does find him, he sets him on his shoulders with great joy. And upon his arrival home, he calls together his friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost sheep." I tell you, in just the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who have no need of repentance. Or what woman, having 10 coins and losing one, will not light a lamp and sweep the house, searching carefully until she finds him? And when she does find him, she calls together her friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found the coin that I lost." In just the same way, I tell you, there will be rejoicing among the angels of God over one sinner who repents. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Sinners to approach him and even if within. He then explained in his typical language that God does not want even one of his children to be lost, and that he overflows with joy whenever a sinner is converted. Jesus is all mercy. Jesus is all love. He is God made man. The meaning of this love is that God accepts us without precondition. Even if we are unworthy of his love or incapable of relating to him, Jesus Christ transforms us and becomes a brother to us. Each of us is that little lost sheep, the corn that was mistaken. Each one of us is that son who was squandered his freedom on false idols, illusions of happiness, and has lost everything. But God does not forget us. The Father never abandons us. He is a patient Father, always waiting for us. He respects our freedom, but he remains faithful forever. And when we come back to him, he welcomes us like children into his house. For he never ceases to wait for us with love. And his heart rejoices over every child who returns. Dear brothers and sisters, how is it possible not to open our hearts to the certainty that, in spite of being sinners, we are loved by God? He never tires of coming to meet us. He is always the first to set out on the path that separates us from him. In the New Testament as a whole, and in the whole of the tradition of the Church, it has always been clear that God desires that everyone should be saved, and that Jesus died not just for a part of mankind, but for everyone. That God himself does not draw the line anywhere. He does not make any distinction between people in his life, people he does not want to have saved, and others whom he prefers. He loves everyone because he has created everyone. That is why the Lord died for all. Therefore, the Eucharist is the sacrament of those who have let themselves be reconciled by God, who has become members of his family and put themselves into his hand. That is why we are conditions for participating in it. It presupposes that we have voluntarily entered into the mystery of Jesus Christ. With the grace and strength we receive through the sacraments and constantly nourished by his love for each one of us, let us strive to make ourselves missionaries of God's love to all peoples.
Please, Lord, listen.
I believe in one God.
Is this the way?
At the time, passion into bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
we dare to say.
These words.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always be well in us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Jesus is continuously seeking and waiting for the lost ones to return home. Let's take courage to approach Him, the face of the Father's mercy. Our priests are available to hear confession every Sunday. Please come early and be prepared.
Dear friends and everyone, there is a wise man saying that there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. FYI, this is the last Mass presided by Father Mac as the parish priest of the Annunciation Church. And this is the time to let you know, Father Joseph Mac, how grateful we are for the 7 years you have served us as our parish priest. We can't thank you enough for the support and understanding, for the spiritual help and guidance, for your enriching homilies and messages of love and inspiration that give us a new and brighter perspective in our journey of faith, for reiterating to us the importance of prayer, hope, and keep trusting in God's unfailing love and mercy when we receive the sacraments, especially of confession and the Eucharist, and for the countless blessings God has given us through you. Thank you for the gift of your priesthood, Father Mac. We see and feel Jesus' gentle, patient, and humble, loving presence in you. And as God sent you to your new parish assignment in Our Lady of China beginning this October, we, the CAPCG, together with Sister Cecil and all the parishioners, send you to with our love, prayer, and blessing. May God give you more strength, wisdom, and vigor as you continue to embrace God's people with joy. May He bless you endlessly and all that you do in your priestly ministry. Thank you for your humble service to the Church of Annunciation and for being patient to all of us. Once again, our sincerest gratitude. God go with you, and we hope to see you again, Father Mark. Also, can we CAPCG take photos with you afterwards, right after the Mass, if possible? Thank you. And so let us rise as we express our hearts with a blessing and well wishes through a song. Thank you.
church together, and also confess the confession of God. Anytime we attend the Mass, it's called in front of us to receive our prayer. So, thank you for all of you who accept my invitation in the past 10 years. But God will bless you to give the prayers better than me. Okay, thank you for all of you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.